Hello students, so in this class I will explain one theory question. From that theory question, first we are having small definitions. What is the first definition here? Population. Population means a group of items, individuals under which reference of study is called population. That means suppose we are studying either group of items, or suppose we are taking here individual also, under which reference of study is called population. Generally population size is denoted by capital N. Now the population may be finite or infinite. What is the definition of finite population? What is the definition of infinite population? Finite population means if the population having finite values, that is called as finite population. If the population having infinite population, that is having infinite population. Next, coming to second definition is sample. Sample means a small part of the population is called sample. Sample size is denoted by small n. Here samples are generally two types. First one is large sample and small sample. If the sample size is n is greater than or equal to 30, is called large sample. So next, coming to here small sample. If the sample size is less than 30, that is called as small sample. So up to here I will explain here one example. Population means suppose I am taking here your class length is maybe 55 students. From that 55 students are coming under to my population. Suppose I am calculating here your class average percentage, for that I am consider your 55 students, that is called as my population. So what about here sample means from that 55 students I am taking here only randomly 10 members. Randomly means that is my choice, without any biasness I am taking the 5 members or 10 members. So suppose I am taking 10 members, that 10 members are called as sample. If I am taking that sample size is greater than or equal to 30, that is called as large sample. Suppose I am taking it less than 30, that is called as small sample. So based on large sample and small sample, we are having different tests. That's why we are separating here what is a large sample and small sample. Next, coming to here types of sampling, generally we are having 3 types. First one is simple random sampling, second one is stratified random sampling, third one is systematic random sampling. So what is meaning of simple random sampling? Simple random sampling means, so randomly we are selecting the sample, that is known as simple random sampling. Suppose we are using, for example, lottery method. Suppose we are having lottery also, we are taking here randomly we are pick up one number, that is known as a lottery method. And suppose we are having chits method also. Chits method means suppose we are rotated here 1 to 55 numbers. So that is your class length is 55 numbers. I noted here 1 to 55 roll numbers. Then I will shuffle that, I will prepare a chits. From the each chit I rotated here one number, then that chits are shuffled. So then I will take here randomly 10 chits. So that chits are called as my sample, that is also called as by chits method. Also we are taking the sample. By base and sample only we are giving the conclusion, that is here way of sampling is the most important. So why we are going to sample method. So suppose population is not available case, we go for the sample. Population is not available case means, suppose I am taking here your class average percentage, for that all students are not attend for any day they are not attend, that's why population is not available. So that's why I go for the sample procedure. Sample procedure means I am taking here only sample 10 members are possible to come all days. So that's why I am going for the sample days. So not only for this example, or we are taking here sample means, suppose I will test here your blood group. For test we are taking here only small sample of blood. We are testing that blood, we are giving the report is either A group or AB group. So like that we are giving the conclusion. So for that I am using here only small sample of blood also, we get the same result. or suppose I am taking the entire blood in your body, that is also I am testing also, I get the same result. So in this method we go for the only sample method. Suppose we are using here entire blood, suppose we are taking here entire blood in our body, then what happen, you know. So that's why we are taking here only small sample case. So sometimes population what is the giving the results, sometimes sample also give the same results, but so we are taking here only less time in sample method. We are going here one more question also based on population sample. I will explain here clearly. Next, stratified random sampling. Second one is stratified random sampling. Stratified random sampling means we are dividing into stratums or ORR groups. From that groups I am selecting here one member, second person also, second group from that also one member, third group also we are having one member. Like that we are dividing the whole data into groups. From that groups I am selecting the sample, that is known as stratified random sampling. Next, coming to here systematic random sampling. From that systematic random sampling I am given here 1 to 55 numbers to you, then I will pick up only first number, fifth number, 10th number, 15th number, 20 number, 25 number. So like that I will go for one other, that is the first one, fifth one, 10th one, 15th one, 20th one, 25th one, 30th. I go for the some fixed values, 5 is difference for everyone. Like that we go for the some systematic manner, that is known as systematic random sampling. These are the mainly three types of sampling: simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, systematic random sampling. Next, one more definition also in our syllabus: purposive sampling. That means in this method a desired number of sample units is selected purposively depending upon the objective of the inquiry, so that only the important item corresponding the true characteristics of the population are included in the sample. So this is a purposive sampling definition. Next, we go for the next question is census versus sample enumeration. Here first I will explain here what is the meaning of census method. Second one is sample enumeration method. First we go for the census method. In the census method we resort to 100% inspection of the population and enumerate each and every unit of the population. In the sample method, suppose we go for the sample method, I am taking it from first person to up to last person. Suppose I am calculating every class average percentage, I will take here from first person to up to last person. 100% of the population is we are having available. In that case we go for the census method. Census methods means suppose I am calculating your class average percentage, each person is available, in that case only we go for the census method. Second point is the census method seems to provide more accurate and exact information as compared to sample enumeration. So sample enumeration we are taking here only some sample observations, but here in this method we are taking here in the census method to provide it more accurate, because we are taking here 100% of the population. We are calculating here any average value, whatever may be anything, we are calculating by using census method. So it is accurate and exact information as compared to sample enumeration. Now third point is the complete enumeration of the population requires lot of money. It takes a lot of time, lot of money and manpower also. Because we are using here total population, that's why it take the time as well as money and manpower. Fourth one is since the entire population is to be enumerated, the census method is usually very time consuming. If the population is sufficient, suppose we are having, so in your class we are having only 50 members. Suppose I am calculating here those who are studying in our entire university or other states also, suppose our India level, those who are studying here agriculture students, I am calculating here agriculture second year students average percentage, second year students average percentage. For that, so it is difficult task, it takes us so much time in this census method. So that's why it is, suppose our population is large, it takes the more time. Next, coming to sample method. So sample method means in population we don't take the entire population. So we are using here different methods. I already explained simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, and systematic sampling. So by using that methods, we can apply any method. By using any method, I can take the sample. So now sample method, now summarize the merits of the sample method very over the census method. So by using sample method, it is very speed means that is the less time, since only a part of the population is to be inspected and examined. The sample method results in considerable amount of saving the time and labor. That means here sample means I am not taking here your entire class. I am taking here randomly 10 members. So 10 members average percentage, it takes only 5 minutes or 10 minutes time. Suppose 55 members average percentage, it takes the half an hour time. So that means this takes only less time. Here I am talking about only Ivama. Otherwise, suppose I am taking here entire in our country, how many students are there studying here? Agriculture second year students, suppose I am calculating entire our India second year students, those who are studying here second year students, their entire average percentage. So we are having different states, in different states also we are having different colleges, from the different colleges also we are taking here. So second year students, that second year students also I am taking here what their marks. So it takes a lot of time by using census method. But sample method I am taking only, so suppose our India base I am taking here only different states, from the different states also we are taking here the randomly I am taking here different states, randomly I am taking here different districts, the districts also I am taking here different villages, what are the colleges are we are having, from that colleges I am taking the information. So that is those who are studying here second year students, from the students I am collecting their marks, and I am calculating here average value. But that average value is I am giving the entire conclusion to entire our India. Suppose we get the value 68%. That means, so those who are studying here second year students in our agriculture in our entire country, their result in our India, their result equal to 86%. Like that we are giving the conclusion. So we go for the census method. What I am saying here, we go for the census method, it takes a lot of time. So by using census, by using sample method, we are pick up only small observations. From that small observations only we are calculating the our what we need here, depend upon only we are calculating here. So this is the speed. Second one is economy. Economy means reduce the cost of the inquiry. The sample method is much more economical than complete census. So compared to census method, its cost is very less. Next, third one is reliability. So in this sample method also, in this census, the sampling errors are be completely absent. If the non-sampling errors also absent, the result would be 100% accurate. Suppose in examination they are asking here, explain differences between census and sample enumeration, or explain census versus sample enumeration. Means you have to explain here these two parts. Census method means we are using here 100% of the data. Sample means we are taking here randomly 5 or 10 observations depend upon data, and we go for the different methods based on our objective. So this is a sample method. Mainly census method it takes more time, but sample method is takes only less time. So speed also depend upon time, so speed also, money also, labors also we are using here so many labors for the census method. Here we are using here only less members we are using here. So this is the advantages of sample method. Thank you.